Hi, it's Ashleigh from Sweet Dreams Bake Shop, and welcome back to my channel where I make a lot of cake and cookie decorating tutorials, as well as give a lot of baking business tips. And as per usual, there will be pricing at the end of this video, so if you want to know how much I would charge for this wreath, then please stay till the very end. So once again, we are back for another Christmas cookie wreath video, and I thought this one would be a little bit more traditional since yesterday it was a little bit more zany. If you missed the video, you can go ahead and check that out in the right-hand corner. So what I'm starting with today is, again, pipe and flood consistency, which is basically the royal icing consistency where you can pipe details like an outline and then you can fill it in without it being chunky and it'll stay nice and smooth. This is not the type of icing consistency you would use if you want to do super, super fine details or pipe things like rosettes. I'm gonna let those parts of the cookie dry before I move on because I wanna make sure that I keep that definition. So I'm moving along to the bow here, and it's basically the exact same bow that I made yesterday. I am going to be doing it a little bit differently. I'm not going to be piping on details after I fill this in. Instead, I'm going to be airbrushing it later on. If you guys are curious about my royal icing recipe, it is 1 cup of powdered sugar to 1 tablespoon of meringue powder, and then add as much water as needed, and you really do need to make sure that you give it quite a good whip. Now I'm going to start working on the berries here, and you might be wondering, hey, in the picture they were not white. We're going to be airbrushing this. Now if you don't want to use an airbrush machine, then what you can do instead is make sure that you use the icing color that you want. But I'm going to be filling this in with pipe and flood consistency white, and then I'm airbrushing it later just so I can get a little bit more definition with it, and it's going to have that realistic flair. Now in my last few videos, I've been using sanding sugar, which I generally do use for sugar cookies because it's nice and fine and it gives you that definition of whatever it is that you're sugaring. But this time around, I'm going to use rock sugar. Because this is a bigger piece and it's a nice big berry that I'm creating, I want to go for something a little bit more coarse. And just a little tip that when you are using large crystals like this, you want to make sure that you just sugar it gently and make sure to take all the excess off, or else your icing is going to get dragged down with it. Now that the leaves have dried, I'm going to go ahead and fill in the rest of it. I'm using the exact same consistency. Now you could do this one of two ways. You could just fill it in completely and then add in line details afterwards. I just find this gives me a little bit more puff and I don't always have to add in those line details anyway. If you want to and you don't own an airbrush machine, you could use lots of different types of greens for this. That would look really, really beautiful. And to make different greens, even if you don't have greens on a spectrum, you could add in more yellow or whatever you like to change up those greens. After I have filled those in, I'm going to go back to the bow and fill this in as well. I want to make a little note here, by the way. This is actually the exact same pink, but I left that piping bag sitting overnight, and it has darkened up. So if you're wondering about saturation of color, you can definitely leave your colors overnight to saturate, but make sure that you re-whip. I find if you don't re-whip, then the icing becomes far too loose, and it doesn't puff up the way that you need it to, especially for pipe and flood consistency. Now I'm going in and I'm adding some details to some of the leaves. Some of the leaves I'm just going to leave plain or just pipe a line down the center. Now I know a lot of us are intimidated about piping straight lines. Make sure that you're holding that piping bag fairly high up. Give a good squeeze at one end and then you're just going to keep maintaining that pressure, bring it over to the other end, and then you're going to finish off just like you would a dot. I then stuck that into the dehydrator just to make sure that the surface was nice and firm so that I could airbrush right away. If you try to airbrush on wet icing, it's going to start to go everywhere and it's going to mess up the integrity of your cookie. I'm just taking a forest green color here in Amerimist. I pretty much only use Amerimist for all of my airbrushing, and originally I had gone towards the edges of the leaves, but I think it looks much better if you go down the veins of the leaves. So going down the center and then making sure that I'm just lightly, lightly airbrushing those veins. Now I'm going to use this pinkish color and I'm going to airbrush that bow, and I'm going to airbrush all of those berries. And this is exactly where we see airbrushing the berries changes the colors completely. And you can really do a large mix of colors if you want to with this portion. You can see I did a little bit of purple on some of them, and I'm also doing some straight pink on a lot of them. I'm also leaving a little white patch blank just to give it that kind of shine look as if the light was bouncing off of it. If I'm in a big rush, I will put that back into the oven or dehydrator just to make sure that the surface is nice and dry, especially if I need to package these right away. Now, there's a couple ways that you can actually put the wreath together. I suggest that you use a cake board underneath, and then you put down some royal icing. I suggest not pipe and flood consistency, but a little bit thickened of a royal icing. Or you can also use my sugar hack, but I will say that's a little bit trickier in this situation, so it's totally up to you. Now let's get into the pricing of this wreath. So yesterday the pricing was a little bit cheaper, but that's also because the wreath was significantly smaller. This is much larger, so I would charge $50 Canadian and would be only a stock order for pre-order only. I would not just have these available on hand. They are a lot of work and there would be no dollar minimums implemented for something like this because it is a stock order. Now let's get into the subscriber submission of the day. I love this cake. It is absolutely vibrant and it is so the colors that I would want on my cake. So be sure to go and check them out, drop them a like and drop them a comment. And if you want to be the next subscriber submission of the video, then please follow me at SD Bake Shop on Instagram, where you can either tag me in a photo or send me a photo of your creation. Any and all dessert levels are welcome. Thanks so much for watching, guys. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe so you can be part of the Sweetie Fam. Right now, I'm uploading weekly, so make sure you hit that notification bell so you know when I upload. Also, be sure to comment, request, or ask a question. I love hearing from you guys. Bye!